All right, good morning, good morning, good morning. Let's get it, let's get it, let's get it. Good morning. Good morning, good morning. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Good morning, good morning, good morning, good morning. How are y'all? Yes, 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 yes. Good morning, good morning. Good morning. Good morning, good morning. Come on in. Good morning. Good morning. How are y'all this morning? Praise the Lord. We got a few minutes. Praise the Lord. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Praise the Lord. Yep. Good morning. This is that time. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Praise the Lord. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. It's that time. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Come on in, y'all. Good morning. There we go. Good morning. 8 o'clock, 8 o'clock, 8 o'clock, 8 o'clock. Good morning. Today, y'all remember 9:30 live, Facebook, Amazing Church on Facebook, Amazing Church. Good morning. 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 Welcome to the 8 a.m. Every day until prayer, call, and fast. Every day until prayer, call, and fast. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Good morning. It's that time. It's that time. Excited about it, y'all. Excited about it. Prayer, call, and fast. It's every day until the quarantine is lifted. Every day until we get past this point, this place, every day, that's what we're doing, 8 o'clock. Today, if you're Amazing Church, I want y'all to make sure that y'all log in at 9:30, go to the Amazing Church YouTube page, subscribe to it. Your children's lessons are there. On this Friday night, our Brush Fire, our student ministry, we had game night where were we at? We were in the Zoom room there. So we got something for everybody in the family this week. I believe that the ladies and the men are going to connect. It just doesn't stop. You can't stop what the Lord is doing. Good morning. Good morning, everybody. Good morning. Good morning, IG. How y'all? Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Praise the Lord. Good morning. Good morning. Y'all are ready. Y'all are ready. Y'all are ready. Y'all are ready. Good morning. Good morning. This is a good stuff. This is a good deal this morning. It's a good deal this morning, y'all. It's about 8:03. Y'all know I got some good music going for you just to saturate yourself this morning to get you ready. I didn't want to steal away from my worship team because I believe that this morning's worship is going to be incredible. Again, excited about it. Excited about it. Listen, this morning, again, I promise you, we're gonna pray this morning. We're praying every morning. It's critical that we do so. We're praying every day until, and it's not going to change. And so, yes, some of you are thinking about our regular fast or the fast that we used to do in the other normal, where we would have all of these things take place except for Sunday morning because we were getting ready to gather. Well, we're doing it this Sunday, or during this fast, we're doing it on Sundays because we're not going to stop until we get lifted past this point, okay? And we're interceding on behalf of, and we're believing that God is going to do, and so that's where our fight is. So this morning, if you would, come on, jump up in there, forward it, share it, create a watch party. If you do a watch party, especially for the broadcast, make sure that you say hello to the people that are on your broadcast. You're broadcasting live. This information is great. Make sure that you do so. This morning, I'm talking about where we are. I'm talking about what creates us to be who we are today. And last night, I was talking to one of the young disciples there. And that's what it's about. It was about, ready? It was about a pain and its ability, what it has the ability to do. Pain matures you, but if you never handle the pain that matures you, you won't mature past that pain, that place of pain or that level of pain. Pain matures you. Once you're handling, you're embracing, you move in it. You don't run away from it. You move through it and past it, and that pain matures you. Here's the deal. If you don't handle it, then you won't mature past that moment of pain. And we've got to understand that. Too often we've been taught that there is no pain. That once you say yes to Jesus, once you're in the body of Christ, the family of God, oh man, everything is cool and it's a done deal. No, we need you to understand. It's critical for you to maintain and stay in the place where you need to be. I believe that God is going to do a whole lot more with us in terms of maturing us and getting us to the places where we need to be. Why is the church not throwing down? Why is the church? Because the church, big C, and the local church, little C, is all connected. It is this church, little C, the gatherings and the coming together. That's where the development takes place. That's what you saw in Acts 2. In Acts 2, you saw where the global, the whole thought process of the church and its spreading around went through the local bodies. It was the disbursement. Why do we think Jesus got 12 disciples? If it was just going to be the big C and be one church, Jesus would only needed one disciple, but it was 12 disciples that we see that were close to him, and there were many disciples around because he sent them out two by twos. We understand this right there in scripture. Even in the upper room, it wasn't 12 guys sitting at a table. That was a rendition of an artist. It actually was about 150 people waiting and hanging around. Jesus came, and if he broke bread with them, as he did, when he came through the door without it opening up, what happened was he distributed that amongst all of them that were there. So we have to get this clear picture. What was the big deal? What was the reason why this happened? I got a lesson that you're going to hear at 9:30. Make sure that you hear that. But I want to get this to you, okay? The Acts Church, and what we're doing right now. Come on, y'all, to give God praise for it. The Acts Church and what we're doing right now is found in Acts, the second chapter, verses 41 all the way down to 47. This is where we are. This is what we're doing. We're screaming out Psalm 91 because it's time to pray and for us to overcome fear. We're screaming out 2 Chronicles 7 and 14 because we need to pray for the Lord to heal the land. But we can't get over Acts 2, 41 through 47 because it's critical for you to understand that nothing is supposed to hinder you from him, just like nothing in Romans 8 will hinder him from you. Nothing. This is a critical piece for you to hear. So I'm going to pray for you. And then after I pray, I'm going to read that passage of scripture to let you know who we are, what we're doing, what is our responsibility, why are things the way they are right now, because this is what we're supposed to be doing. Come on, let's give God praise for it. It's going to be a beautiful thing that happens on today, all across the world, through the electronic media, through telephony, through telecommunications. The word of God is being sent around the world, and people, good morning, Washington, D.C., Miss Brenda, hear me. This is critical. People all around the world have access now to those of us who didn't want to do it, but we're forced into it. Some didn't want to because of quality. Some didn't want to because they didn't have the resources. Some, there are many, many reasons, a plethora of reasons. Some reasons why we're still looking for the rotary dial phone. It's because God is saying, my church can't be left behind. She must continue on because the gospel must continue on throughout all generations. And some are doing it well, but we've got to get this whole thing together. And it's not just the telecommunications component. It is the ability for the gospel to get to places where it never reached before. Now, in the remote regions, in third world countries, and for some of you, you're not aware of it, even in fourth world places, untouched people, indigenous to the areas that they're in, the only reason why we know they're there is because of discovery. The Lord is not going to leave a person without the opportunity to receive the gospel. And it's because of Acts 2. It's not because of anything outside of that for us as an assignment. Our assignment is Matthew, yes, 19, but it is here also in Acts 2. And so I'll absolutely love, thank everybody for being here on the call this morning. Thank y'all for getting up. Thank y'all for giving God all that you have. And I promise you, this won't be anything that you will forget. You will remember this for the rest of your days. Let part of your memory be the fact that you were faithful to the Father, that you were faithful to God and faithful to His church and being His church, being able to mature past the pain. Remember that there is no maturity without pain. And the pain that you don't handle, you won't mature past that point. There is no maturity without pain. And the pain that you don't handle, you will not mature past that point. So that point of pain. And this is a place of different kinds of pain. There's some physical pain, some emotional pain, some mental pain, some strain and pain. But you've got to be able to manage that moment and don't go stir crazy, lose your mind, or just throw up your hands and don't care anymore. No, you got to handle this. This is maturity. This is for grown folk. You got to come on with it. And us that have children that need our hands, let's make sure that we lead and guide them. Are y'all ready to pray this morning? I'll read this passage of scripture when I'm done. Father, we thank you so much this morning for giving us an opportunity to gather together as people so that, God, we can give you this praise out of our hearts, this place, this opportunity for us to magnify you. Lord, we magnify you this morning. We magnify you. We lift your name high. We open up our hearts and our minds and our mouths, God, will follow. And this proceeding, God, out of our mouths is our love and our care, our affection, our praise towards you. You're a wonderful God. You're a wonderful Father. You care about us and you see us and you know us and you're mindful of us, God. You'll never leave us and you'll never forsake us. Your name is a strong tower and we who are righteous can run in unto it. And Father, there is no good thing that you shall withhold from them that walk uprightly before you. God, you go before us and you're behind us. You have given us an opportunity to come before you to cast our cares upon you, for you care for us. God, we love you this morning. We thank you this morning. We praise you. We understand, God, that your word is true. All the promises of God are yes and amen in Christ Jesus. So we thank you for those of us that are in Christ Jesus, God, that we have access to your promises. So Lord, bring to us through your Holy Spirit the access, the remembrance, the things, God, that will change and lift and put us in position, God, to see and to know how good and great you are. We understand, God, through our existence that you've been good, that you're not just good now, but you've been good. And we thank you, Lord God, that your word says that there will none that will be beside you or come alongside you, God, and be able to be compared to who you are. We understand, God, that these light afflictions cannot be compared to the glory which shall be revealed in us through you because we're in Christ Jesus. So we thank you, Lord God. We thank you, Father, for being our Father. We thank you, Father, for being there. We thank you, Father, for when our earthly fathers weren't there, God, you would always cause a surrogate to come in place. We thank you, Father, that when they were there, you would always give them the wisdom. We thank you, Lord God, for mothers and for those that are part of our family of origin. We thank you for our mothers that stood in the gap, that held us together, that kept us, God, and made sure, Lord God, that we got closer to you like we never have before. God, so we thank you. Your word says, God, that when we're obedient to our parents, it is the first commandment with a promise. So we thank you for the promise of our parents. We thank you, Lord God, for putting them in our lives. We thank you, Lord God, for giving us the patterns that we need to have. And God, when they didn't know better, you would always, God, always offer a way of escape and provide a surrogate so that we would have an opportunity, God, to come closer to you. You are the answer. You are the way. You are the only way. And we thank you, Lord God. We thank you now, God. We thank you because you are a good Father. And a good Father, God, you are always cared for us and we're your children. And so, God, we don't get too high and too above ourselves in the thinking of ourselves. We humble ourselves. Your word says when we humble ourselves before you, Lord God, that you will hear us and you will answer us. When we humble ourselves before you, Lord, we have the power to resist the devil and he will flee. God, we thank you. When we humble ourselves, your word says that you resist the pride and you push them away, but you draw, God, and you lift up the humble. And so we humble ourselves before you, not so that we can get lifted up, God, but so that we'll be able to be in your presence. We want your presence. We want to be next to you. We want to be able to, Father, come to towards your throne without fear of being removed, without fear of being rejected. We thank you, Lord God, that you always accept us and that your word is very clear. We thank you, Father, for all the ability that we have today is because you have forgiven us and didn't condemn us for our sins. Your word says, God, that there is now therefore no condemnation for them that love you and walk after the Spirit. And so we walk after the Spirit. Thank you, God, for giving us this pattern. Thank you for giving us this plan. Thank you for giving us this access. God, this morning, we give you praise this morning. We ask that you forgive us for all of our sins that we are aware of, the things that we are not, the sin, God, of disobedience, what we knew to do that we didn't do. We ask, God, that you forgive us for that sin of omittance. God, in Jesus' mighty name, your word says that if we confess our faults one to another, that we're healed. But when we confess to you, O Father, you're faithful and just to forgive and to cleanse all unrighteousness, that you, Father, will remember it no more, that you, O God, we come together collectively, that you, God, will purge us with hyssop and wash us and make us white as snow. This is your promise to us. We receive it now. We thank you for your promise to us, God. We thank you for all that you have put us in position to know by your word. Thank you that your word is true. Thank you that your word is alive. Thank you that it is well. Thank you that it is sharper than any two-edged sword. Thank you, Lord God, for the whole armor of God, the helmet of salvation. Thank you, Lord God, the breastplate of righteousness. Thank you, O Lord God, that we have the shield of faith that quenches all the fiery darts of the enemy. Thank you for the shield, God, because the attack of the enemy is clear. The attack of the enemy is prevalent. The attack of the enemy will not cease. So thank you, Lord, for giving us the shield. God, giving us the big shield and little shield. God, that covers us from head to toe. Thank you for your word, which is the sword, which is the truth, God, that we can utilize. Thank you that your word comes alive and it comes out of us. For as it is in our heart, God, your word says that have your word have we have hid in our heart that we might not sin against you. Lord, we thank you that you're putting your word on the inside of our heart. We thank you that we understand that faith comes by hearing, and that hearing comes by the preached word of God. We thank you that faith comes by hearing, and that hearing comes from your word, God, that is being taught to us, your word that is being spoken to us, your word that we're reading and the voice that we're hearing. God, may we have an ever desirable and insatiable appetite for your word, for faith come by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. We thank you. We give you praise this morning. Thank you for giving us the opportunity to come together by way of this telecommunication, by way of these opportunities, these devices. Thank you, Lord God, for giving us the opportunity to come together, God, all over places. Nothing will be able to separate us. Hallelujah. Nothing will be able to separate us. We give you glory for it from the love of God through Christ Jesus and through those who are following and obedient to the assignment. Thank you, Lord God. We give you praise. Praise God. Thank you this morning for every person that got up and decided, I'm going to make the prayer call today. I'm going to make the prayer live today. I'm going to make the prayer IGTV today. I'm going to get on and give God glory this morning by being a part of those that are up early to intercede. If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves, turn from their wicked ways, seek my face, then I will hear them and I will heal the land. Thank you, Lord God. And it's not just the land that we're interceding for. Heal bodies now in Jesus' mighty name. Restore people back into their proper mindset and place, God. We bind the enemy and his attack, and we will continue until we see what we were believing for, what we're praying for, what we're focused in on. God, by faith, you said whatsoever things we desire when we pray, to believe that we receive them and we shall have them. You told us to speak to the mountain and the mountain shall be removed. You said that you are our shepherd and we should not want. You make for us to lie down in green pastures, and you lead us beside still waters. You restore our soul. You're the restorer of our soul. You lead us in the path of righteousness for your name's sake. And yea, though we walk through the valley of the shadow of death, we will fear no evil, for you are with us. Your rod and your staff, they comfort us. You prepare a table before us in the presence of our enemies. You anoint our head with oil, and our cup runs over. You said goodness and mercy shall follow follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in your house, dwelling right now in the name of the Lord forever and ever. You are our Father who art in heaven, and holy is your name. Your kingdom come and your will be done here on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us of our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Father, we give you praise for it. Come on, somebody give him praise for it. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endureth forever. Because they rebelled against the words of God and contended with him, the counsel of the Most High. That is what happens to people when they get beside themselves and they try to draw themselves from God. What is it that you desire to do so much so that you're willing to deny the existence and or the authority of God? Don't rebel. Don't contend with him. He is a powerful God, and he loves it when we come together. Oh, how beautiful it is when brethren dwell together in unity. It is like the dew upon Mount Hermon, even upon Aaron's beard, and it comes down. Y'all, that's the word of the Lord. Let's come on. In the name of the Lord Jesus, it says, behold how good and pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. It is like the precious ointment upon the head that came down upon the beard, even Aaron's beard, that went down to the skirts of his garment, as the dew of Hermon and as the dew that descended upon the mountains of Zion. For there the Lord commanded the blessing, even life evermore. Come on, glory to God. We thank you, Father, for giving us life evermore. You're concerned about us. You're mindful of us. You have been speaking to us through your psalm. You have been speaking to us through all of those that have written your word. Your word is alive, and we thank you for it. But it is good for us to draw near to God. We have put our trust in the Lord that we may declare all of his works. Come on, we're declaring his works. God, we're declaring your works. We love you this morning. We give you praise this morning. And we're kind one to another as your word has commanded, singing psalms and hymns over each other in the name of the Lord Jesus. This morning, we give you praise. This morning, we give you glory. This morning, we magnify you. This morning, you're worthy of all the praise. God, we love you this morning. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God, for another day. Thank you, Lord God, for a sane mind. Thank you, Lord, that we haven't gone crazy. Thank you, Lord God, that we haven't lost our own existence, our whole totality. Thank you, Lord, that we're dealing with something that we actually are able to fight. Thank you, Lord God, for all of those that have gone on. We thank you that you're soothing the hearts of those family members, and especially, God, when it's tragic. But God, also, we want to thank you for recovery. We want to thank you that you've given us a picture of hope, that some people, Father God, and matter of fact, more people than that have died have overcome. And we thank you, Lord God, that you're making us and giving us the opportunity to overcome. We love you. We're giving you our heart. We give you everything we have, God. We don't leave anything on the table. We're not reserving our lives for ourselves, thinking that we know what's better for us. But God, in Jesus' name, this morning we woke up and dedicate ourselves to you. Whatever you want to do, God, in the name of the Lord Jesus, you have our best interest at heart. You have a plan for us to give us hope and a future. And so, God, we want you to lead and guide us by your Holy Spirit in that direction. And we give you thanks. We give you praise. It's in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Come on. Somebody give him praise this morning. Somebody thank him this morning. He's worthy this morning. He is not to be mistaken with somebody else. He is our God. He is the one who understands. He knows better than any of us know. He is God and God all by himself. Come on. If you're on the live, do the hearts and the thumbs up. If you're on the live, I guess both of them are live. If you're on Instagram, go ahead. Let's give God some praise. Let's let him know that we give him glory together. We've come together. We made this thing happen. It's going to be incredible. It's going to be incredible. I promise you. Take a look at this. This is what's happening. This is what's happening. It says in Acts the second chapter, verse 41, all right, and I'm gonna come back to 42, but I'm going to read all the way through. It says, then they that gladly received his word were baptized, and the same day were added unto them about 3,000 souls. It says, and they continue steadfastly in the apostles' doctrine and fellowship and in breaking of bread and in prayers. And fear came upon every soul, and many wonders and signs were done by the apostles. And all that believed were together and had all things common, and sold their possessions and goods and parted them to all men as every man had need. And they continuing daily with one accord in the temple and breaking bread from house to house, did eat their meat with gladness and singleness of heart, praising God and having favor with all people. And the Lord added to the church daily such as should be saved. Get this, 42, and they continue steadfast in the apostles' doctrine and fellowship and in breaking of bread and in prayers. All right, so this is something that we're seeing right now. We're connecting every day. We're going with this word every day. We're praying and talking to God every day. We're inviting the Spirit of God in with us every day. We're going over this teaching and this word. We're parting and we're sharing every day. Any time I look somewhere, the church of the living God is helping someone, is touching someone. It's a beautiful thing. And we're doing it all across different platforms, making it happen. The word of God is going forth so much more now than when we were in our own silos in our buildings. I'm telling you, this is a beautiful thing. We got to see the beauty in what God is doing. We got to see the beauty in what this opportunity is. And then when we are able to be released and what they say back together again, hear me very clearly. It says that we fellowship. Fellowship cannot happen just across the means or these medians. This is connectivity, but fellowship comes when we come together. This is connecting, but fellowship comes when we come together. Breaking bread can't happen here. I can break bread here, but I can eat it, and you can symbolically participate as we will do with our communion on next Saturday or this coming Saturday. We can do it, but it won't necessarily be fellowship. He says fellowship, and then it comes down again and says that, I believe, in 47. In 47, it says, 46. And they continue daily with one accord in the temple and breaking bread from house to house. They did it in the temple, and they did it from house to house. This is how we fellowship. This is how we connect, guys. We make this thing happen. So when this is over, we're going to have one incredible, we're going to have an amazing party so that we can fellowship and get back together. I miss y'all. I miss seeing you, shaking your hands, hugging you. Having the power of God released in a corporate setting is incredible. But I also tell you this, I love what God is doing here. You guys are connecting with other people and bringing them in, and you can do this the same way. So we love you. We're excited about it. Again, remember, this is the Everyday Until fast and prayer. You will pray in the mornings at 8 a.m. every morning, and then after your first meal, you won't eat for 4 hours after that. That's the fast component. Today, 9:30 and 11:15 are our broadcast live for Amazing Church. Yeah, I'm telling y'all, that's right. It's going to happen. It's going to happen today. Make sure that you log into your Facebook, and I believe also might be Instagram. I'm not sure, but I know it'll be Facebook Live. Let's focus in on a spot there, Facebook Live, and then we'll rebroadcast it so people can see it again. But I want as many of you to get on at 9:30 and 11:15, our normal experience times. That's experience in person. This is experience online. Make sure this is you, make sure that you do so. And then, as I already stated, go to our YouTube page, Amazing Church YouTube page, and your kiddos, their lesson has already been loaded up and ready to go. Today's teacher is Miss Ashley. It's going to be incredible. Make sure that you get them there. It's something. And like I told you, we have some for our youth, our young adults, men and women. It's all coming down and flowing in. We are doing it. So let's do it well. Folks, obey the CDC guidelines. Do that. Obeying the laws of the land, the Lord has our best interests at heart. This is not challenging your faith. This is not telling you to disown Jesus. This is just saying for the ability of us to function. This is what we desire to do. I've already taught that lesson once, and I'll say it again and again. Jesus said to Satan, who said, cast yourself down, the angels will pick you up. Jesus said, you know what, that's real true, but there's also written, the word says, don't tempt the Lord your God. What that means is, there's no need to try God. The only place God says through his prophet Malachi to try him is in giving of your stuff. If you want to try God, try that part. Hallelujah. Instead of playing with your life, why don't you use what you spend your life on? And if you want to try, try it. But as far as going out and going, I don't have any fear, that doesn't prove that you have no fear. That proves that you might be foolish and that you are not paying attention to the instructions that God has already given. All right, so let's obey what they've shown us. Let's meet back here tomorrow morning at 8 a.m. Let's tear this thing up and let's win this battle. We're in and we're going to win it, and we're going to win it well. All right, I love y'all. Have a great, great morning. Be blessed.